Welcome back to the workshop. As usual, we've got something cool on the bench for you, doing a full build review of this one. This is round two, MPC 125th scale Mountain Goat Jeep Commander. This is a re-release. It's going to be with a lot of options in it. You've got three-wheel options, two-tire options. Let's look at everything that's going to be in the box. First up will be the manual. Takes you through 19 steps in a fold-out manual. Make sure you pay attention with your suspension blocks, whether you want to lift the Jeep or build it more as a stock height. Make sure you pay attention to that in the manual. We've got an expanded decal sheet. We got those nice 70s retro graphics. We've got two sets of license plates. We got numerous Jeep emblems in black and white. We've got white Mountain Goat emblems, if you can see those show up with the way the light bounces off that white. We've got Commando logos for the fenders. That's your new expanded decal sheet. Let's start taking a look at the plastic. Be careful with that body. It's quite delicate. A lot of these parts are thin. It's a lot of parts in here, and they're pretty detailed, which makes them thin and fragile. So take your time. We'll take a look at that body. These kits are molded in a metallic, pearlish style blue. And you know what? I think I'm just going to leave it that way. It's nice and glossy. Just give it a little bit of brass polish, a little bit of oven cleaner polish, and I'll show that in a little bit here. Just a little once over and a dry off, and I think you'll be just fine. Now you see all these different structures in here. Those pieces will be removed as you build the kit, but since the body is so fragile, they mold those in place and keep it from crushing. We've got the nice frame here, which is, we'll put it back here, flip it over. It's straight. There's no issues. It's not bent. It's not warped. That is always lovely. We've got all kinds of different parts here. We've got roll bars, optional roof, canvas top for the Jeep. We've got our dual roll bars there for the back. I'll be painting a lot of the other stuff, but I honestly think I'm going to try and leave the body that metallic blue plastic. I like that. Got our leaf springs. We've even got an optional trailer hitch and a hitch for whatever you want to attach behind it. Little cool additional parts there. Here we've got one set of wheels. Steelies, you know I'm going with those, probably. I think I'm going to build this stock height. We've got our spare tire, exhaust system, linkages, inner fenders. We got that hood. We got some radiator part there. Start looking at some other stuff. We'll start throwing some trees out here. The only colored plastic in the kit is blue. A lovely deep blue. The rest is chrome, clear, and vinyl tires. Got a set of springs there, two drive shafts, shocks, engine halves, manifolds, drive line, and steering. We've got our interior panels, which have nice detail on them. Grills, radiator, dashboard there, center console, tailgate, gas tank, steering wheel, steering column, even a separate battery. Tons of detail in this thing. I've never built it before. You can see the seats here. More panels. We've got our interior firewall. You can see the bottom of the interior chassis pan. We've got our optional big tires for the off-road tires that they include, and the wheel backs. And more wheel backs. We don't need to concentrate on those. We'll get that out of the way. Let's get some chrome and clear out here. Lots of parts. We got red clear. Easy to spot. We've got clear clear, which is completely flat, being this type of vehicle, and you can see distortion free. No problems with that at all. We've got two little chrome trees. We've got a set of stock Jeep wheels. You've got five of those. There's another one on the tree. We've got a set of turbines. Got our grill, bumpers, valve covers, shifters, mirrors, pedals, all kinds of chrome goodies in there that you can either strip and paint, or chrome, or dull down, whatever your little heart desires. Last but not least, we've got our tires. We've got two full sets of tires in this kit. These are Goodyear Suburbanites. Nice stock 70s bias ply looking off-road tires. You get four of those. And if you want to go the big jacked up Jeep look, we've got the Formula Desert Dogs. Great tread on those. All right, That's everything that's going to be in the box. I'm going to get in the parts washer as usual. I'm going to start doing some sub-assemblies. I really think I'm going to leave that body the exact blue that it came in out of the box. I like that. So we'll go over a little bit of plastic polishing. We'll be back. Welcome back. We've been working for a couple hours on this one. We've got most of the sub-assemblies done. Now it's time to head over for the fun stuff, to start spraying the colorful liquids all over the vehicles. We're going to start painting now. I am not painting the body. I definitely made that decision. I threw some gloss right over the top of the factory plastic, that metallic pearlescent blue, and I just love it. You can see the bottom side. We're going to leave alone, but throw a gloss on there, and we're not done. We got to give it another coat, but that's just good old Tester's gloss coat, and man, the metallics come out of that. It's really sharp looking. I'm going to leave that alone. There's not a lot of times where I don't paint the plastic, but the body has got its clear coat on it now, and it's a really nice metal flake look, which is total 70s for this vehicle. I've got the wheel backs glued together, and I test fitted them on each axle to make sure they fit. I've got the wheel backs there, and we got the steelies and the exhaust. I'm going to be doing those in a metallic tone. So I've got those trees together. I'll be clamping them and spray painting them. Got some stuff test fit together. It's an excellent idea when you do the roll bars, if you do use them, to test fit them and glue them together on the body. The locator pinholes are in the perfect place. They fit easily. And then you can glue everything in place, set it on the side, let it dry, come back. It's all ready to go. So you can see that is all ready for paint now, and I know it's perfectly lined up. We've got the back seat put together. The back seat's going to sit back there. Definitely got to put that in there. We've got the interior tub done. We'll slide this over here. We've got the interior tub done. I've got the dash loose so I can paint and accent the dash. I just attached the steering column because it just fits into a U-shape on the bottom. So I want to make sure I got that in with my bonding so that it's a really strong meld. I've got the firewall in. I've got the door panels on, and I've got the seats just loosely tossed inside. You can see those nice bucket seats. We've got to paint those. I'm going to be going with a tan interior. I like the look of it on the box, and that's what I'm going to stick with. But the interior tub goes together nicely. The firewall goes on, and it all self-aligns in there. So that's all ready to go. Don't cut off these little pins on the bottom of your interior tub. They're not from the injection process. They are actually going to help it line up with those two cross members on the frame so that it locks solidly in place. Speaking of the frame, we've got the complete frame and drivetrain done, except for the drive shafts. I haven't attached because that's going to be a little bit of a trickier alignment. I'm going to paint those outside. The inner fenders are on the frame. They key in to little parts right in there. I've got the radiator and the shroud on as they instruct. Check out all the detail on that front end. They've got steering links, they've got sway bar links, all that built in there is all individual parts. So take your time and it'll line up just fine, and keep lining up your axles and your springs so that you get it set. Now I've got factory height suspension. They do have lifting blocks in the kit on some other leaf springs and stuff like that, so you can jack it up a little bit for those bigger tires, get the better clearance. But I wanted to go with the stock wheels, those nice Goodyear Suburbanite tires, and get that ready to go. So that's all set. The V6 here, nice looking little engine. I did attach the chrome parts already because it's going to be just getting a coat of AMC Jeep Blue. That's the color I want to go with the motor. Some black accents, change the color of the filter here, cover the air cleaner, the POV. I can do that all by hand. And the transmission and the transfer case are all attached. Check out how those manifolds attach. On the passenger side, it goes backwards like you always think it would. But to clear different suspension and steering, the front manifold faces forward and loops back around so we can connect it with the head pipe and the exhaust. That's everything in the sub-assemblies. It took a couple hours to clip, snip. Nothing had to be pushed or shoved or yanked in alignment. Everything went through together fine. A little bit of flash, but nothing worth worrying about. Mostly it disappeared when you just put the glue on it and it melted away and helped the part fit. So this is everything that's going over to paint. We're going to be doing some black and tan. And then the motor will be painted by hand as always, because that's much easier to do. I'll be back when I got some stuff painted. Plus, we'll take a look at that body when it's all done drying. It's progress report time on the build. As you can see, I just kind of set the body over the frame there. But everything's going well. We've got the 304 V8 painted up. Under the hood, we got the fenders on, radiator. We got the radiator hose on. We've got the exhaust on underneath. We've got both drive shafts in. We've got the wheels and tires painted and mounted. What I did with the wheels to cover up that dark blue was I first painted them a metallic color. Then I went over them with the white so that the dark rings would show through and the bolts and the lug nuts and everything would show through, but that it wouldn't be that a bluish tint to the white behind it. So I did paint that metallic to get that to show off. Everything else went together fine, painted up black, did my technique with the silver pencil where I rub it all around there to give a little wear. I still have to mount the bumpers. I've got the grill washed. Now I just have to paint and detail the lights on the front. Got the roll bar painted. Got the interior done over here. That looks real nice. They give you that chrome gauge cluster. Just give that a deep wash. I did it on a brown on brown, a deep brown for the seats, and a light brown for the interior and the back. Let's take a look at how that blue is going to look. That's going to come out real nice, that metallic blue. Got the brush guard painted. And we've got the taillights brush metaled on the back there. So we're going to have to start just mounting all the little stuff together. I've got to put the interior inside the body, then secure both to the chassis. I've been test fitting that to make sure it works well. I'm going to keep putting all these things together, get the hood on, get the grill on, do all the final detailing. We come back, this lucky guy is going to be all done. We'll see you soon. Welcome back for the final on the MPC Mountain Goat. Haven't seen this kit in a while. Everyone's excited about it coming out. You can see why. It's a really cool kit. My review of the kit, I think it's a nice kit. I'm glad it's back out. I recommend it for people that have had at least a few other kits under their belt. Not because of a lot of fit issues. There wasn't any big problems with that whatsoever. The only thing was some of the parts are very, very small on this kit, especially the chassis that I showed you earlier. Some of those steering linkages, sway bars are super small. It's a lot finer parts than other kits you'll see on the market. So if you had a few kits underneath your belt, you can build this without a problem whatsoever. You can build it a more stock version like I have done. And I kind of did a variation on the decals. I didn't do the across the hood decals. I didn't use the big 4x4 decals on the box. I went with and I just cut the stripes out and I made it look like it's got a little bit of the cool 70s accent with a larger Jeep emblem over the Commando emblem and instead put the red Commando on the fender. I prefer that. How about that metallic blue that it's molded in? That is absolutely beautiful. I just shot that after I polished it up. What I used was a glass cleaner for glass cook stoves and buffed it down just so I could make sure I got rid of any rough points. And then I shot it with Tester's gloss coat. And that's what you get. You can see the interior looks real sweet on there with that brown and tan. I really like how that came out with the accents. And I just did some light washing on those panels to bring out those details. And the same with the dashboard. Everything looks nice. I did the roll bar. I didn't use the CB antenna. I didn't use some of the other accessories on there. I wanted it to be more like a street version instead of a big rock crawler off-road version. Told you what I did with the wheels. Base coated them with a metallic silver first. Then shot them with a white to get rid of that blue look. Otherwise, just a real nice kit. It's got the V8 option underneath the hood. That grill turned out nice. I did use the brush guard. I thought that looked real sweet on there surrounding the grill. And once again, I love that metallic blue. I think that came out so sweet. I'm glad I did it that way. The glass went in smooth. The interior assembled real smooth. I like how the interior snaps onto the chassis with those four pins. You can glue those down and it holds tight. When you're all done, you build it my version or the other version with a lift on it. You're still going to have a set of tires left over. You're still going to have two sets of wheels, all extras. And of course, I use the Mountain Goat license plate. So that's it. That's the full build on the re-release Mountain Goat. There'll be a link in the description, as always, where you can get yours. No description of the paint because it came metallic blue out of the box, and that's sweet. I'll see you at the next review. Thanks for watching. HPI Guys Model Workshop.